Russian President Vladimir Putin is politically immortal. He is here to stay as president for quite a long time. Now, as much as that upsets leaders of the West, Putin is succeeding in his campaign against Kremlin critics. Alexei Navalny has not been harmed, but his movement is being dismantled on a daily basis. The Kremlin critic is losing the game in Russia, and Putin is overpowering his movement. Hi, and welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host, Sanbir Ranhotra, and in this video, we'll explain how leaders of the West bet on the wrong man in Russia and are having to eat humble pie now. There are a few things in the world that cannot be changed. Russia's president is one of them. Vladimir Putin is here to stay as the Russian president, and the West made a very big mistake by trying to rally behind Kremlin critic Alexei Navalny. US President Joe Biden and other Western leaders like German Chancellor Angela Merkel tried to capitalize upon Navalny's opposition campaign against Putin. They were probably hopeful of a regime change in Moscow. However, Putin is now winning the big battle against jailed opposition leader Alexei Navalny, whose movement against the Russian president seems to be losing steam. As per the New York Times, associates of Alexei Navalny are disbanding his nationwide network of 40 regional offices. Leonid Volkov, one of Navalny's aides, said that the move became inevitable given how Moscow has been stifling political dissent. Volkov said, "Alas, we must be honest. It's impossible to work under these conditions." He added, "We are officially disbanding the network of Navalny offices." Russian authorities have actually imposed a wave of restrictions on Navalny's organizations, which has made it practically impossible for them to operate in Russia. Ivan Jadanov, the group director of Navalny's anti-corruption foundation, said that on April 27th, a Russian court imposed sweeping bans on the group. He said that FBK has been banned from posting content on the internet, accessing state media, organizing demonstrations, participating in elections, and using bank accounts.
Meanwhile, the Russian court has designated FBK and Navalny's nationwide network of regional campaign offices as extremist organizations. Now, Navalny's organizations would be put at par with other organizations like the Islamic State Group and Al-Qaeda in Russia.
Moreover, once Navalny's organizations are labeled extremist organizations, then even the faintest of support to the Kremlin critic will get criminalized. The members will also have to face lengthy prison terms, as the activities of Navalny's organizations will get outlawed. Also, Russian authorities have asked Alexei Navalny's offices to halt their activity, as the court is still deciding whether to ban them with an extremist designation. Navalny himself has sought to continue opposition against Putin even from prison. In an online court appearance, Navalny vowed to keep fighting the emperor with no clothes in the Kremlin. But does Alexei Navalny's continued opposition against Putin even matter? Make no mistake, Navalny might continue his fight against Putin, but his movement has no real support. Navalny's associates have realized that there is no sense in operating his organizations any further, and as such, the Kremlin critic stands abandoned. From the very beginning, it seemed clear that Putin would ultimately succeed in overpowering his critics. As for the Western world, it was betting on the wrong man. The Biden administration was warning Russia of consequences if anything happened to Navalny in Russian custody. But now we know that Putin never really wanted to eliminate the Kremlin critic. Rather, Moscow has systematically extinguished his organizations. Putin has outfoxed both Navalny and the Western world. Alexei Navalny lives on, so there are no consequences against Moscow, but Navalny's political campaign against Putin is definitely dead.